Since I've received some questions about textures in the past week, I wanted to make a quick video to explain a few basic concepts while I'm in between longer tutorial videos. A texture is essentially an image that wraps around the surface of your model. However, in 3D games, there are several texture types that can contribute to a single material or shader. We will quickly walk through the two most common types that you will come across when dealing with video game models in particular. I will be simplifying for the sake of brevity, so definitely check out the resources linked in the description. Let's take this example model. The first texture is the diffuse or color texture. It is the plain color information of your model. This is probably the first thing you will think of when you think of a texture. When searching for a model's textures, these will be the easiest to recognize. The file name will usually contain the words diffuse, diff, color, or col. In Blender, this is usually what you want to plug into the base color. Wow, looks like we're done here. Actually no, let's disconnect the diffuse again and look at our geometry. This model doesn't actually have a lot of detail. It's very simple geometry. This brings us to the second texture type, which is the bump map, also known as a normal map. The file name will usually contain the words NRM, norm, or bump. In Blender, we set the color space of this type of texture to non-color and connect it to the normal input of our shader through a normal map node. What did this achieve? It may not be immediately obvious, but this texture adds fake surface detail, adding subtle shadows and highlights without changing any of the geometry. The limitations of this should be clear. It is not actually displacing polygons and adding details, so this effect isn't perfect. But it is very fast to calculate and thus very popular for use in real-time graphics. In our case, it's made a subtle but noticeable difference, especially on the chest and near the horns. Changing the light position around and toggling the textures on and off makes a difference pretty clear. The normal map will often have this bluish tint. This is because the red and green channels contain the height data for the X and Y axis and the blue channel for the Z axis. The blue channel is often the brightest and will therefore determine the appearance of the texture as a whole. These are called tangent space normal maps. Some game engines will swap these channels around, resulting in green or red looking normal maps. With some experience, you can easily recognize and compensate for this by swapping these channels. Some games like Skyrim will use object space normal maps. You can recognize this by their wide array of colors instead of the more common uniform blue. And that's all for now. This is the part where you subscribe to the channel and pledge to our Patreon. More videos about Blender and Source Filmmaker are coming soon.